Hey there, Measure Geeks, Julian here, and today my friend and Facebook expert from Vertex Media, Cedric, is going to show you how to send an event into the Facebook ad system via the Conversion API and Zapier. The Conversion API is a new way to send Facebook events into the ad system. Now, traditionally, you might have done this via the normal Facebook pixel that you install on your site, but how can you send data from places where you can't install a pixel, like a Google form? And that's exactly what Cedric is going to show us today. So Cedric, take it away.
Thanks, Julian. Hey, my name is Cedric, and in this video, I will be showing you how to send an event using the Facebook Conversion API. And in this video, I'll be showing you how to do it using Zapier. So now let me share my screen and I'll show you how to do it. So I'm going to be starting in my Zapier account and I'm going to create a Zap. Now we need to add a trigger. So the trigger is actually going to be the place where you're pulling the data from in order to send it to the Facebook Conversion API. So in this example, I'm actually going to be using a Google form. And when I submit the form, it's going to add automatically this information that I have in the form in this demo spreadsheet. And that's exactly where I'll be pulling the data from. So you might use Active Campaign as your trigger, or if you use HubSpot, you might use HubSpot, but it doesn't really matter as long as you're pulling that information that we need in order to send it to the Conversion API. And I'll show you exactly what that information is in just a second. So I'm gonna click on Google Forms and I'm gonna trigger this when a new response in spreadsheet, just choosing my account. I'm going to choose a spreadsheet, and that's my spreadsheet, Demo Zapier, and the worksheet form response. Now, I'm going to submit the form, and if we look here, the value has been added. So I am submitting the timestamp, and this timestamp is in unique seconds of the actual event, the first name, the last name, email, phone number, address, city, province, country, postal code, and the value. So those are all the different parameters that I have in this Google Sheet. I'm going to hit continue, test the trigger, and perfect. We can sort of see the information is appearing here. So I'm going to click continue. Now what we need to do is we need to tell Zapier that we want to send this information to the Facebook Conversion API. So I'm going to type Facebook conversions, and make sure you click this one here, Facebook conversions and not Facebook offline conversions, as those are two different things. In this example, I am sending an event and I'm sending that event when a user purchased something. So I'm going to click on send purchase event. But if you want to send something like a lead event, obviously you would send the lead event right below here. But I'm going to be sending a purchase event. I just need to sign into Facebook. Hit continue. Now I'm going to need to pick my action source. So for this demo, we're going to pretend that someone went on the website and then purchased an item. So this action happened on my website. So I'm going to choose the website option. Now I'm just going to choose my business account associated with the pixel that we want to send the information to. And I'm going to choose my pixel. And I'm going to choose my demo pixel. Now this is where we need to add the event information. So we're going to need to start by adding the event time, but please keep in mind that the event time needs to be in this format here. So it needs to be a timestamp, but a unique timestamp in seconds. So if I click here and click timestamp, it's going to get added into the event info of my Zap. One thing they're saying here is that if this is empty when your Zap fires, they will automatically add a timestamp in this box. But if you read Facebook's documentation, they actually don't recommend that, especially if you're using a lower Zapier plan, because sometimes there could be a delay of up to 15 minutes. And Facebook is really clear in their documentation that the event time needs to be the exact time in seconds of when the event happened on your website or in your app. So using the timestamp of the Zap is not best practice. Now the event ID, so this is actually what you can use to remove duplicates when sending the same event from more than one source. So if you are sending something like a purchase event via the Facebook conversion API, exactly like what we're doing today, but you also want to send an event for a purchase event using the Facebook pixel via the browser, well, you actually need to add an event ID that is unique so that Facebook, when they see those two events coming in, they can see that this is the same ID. But in this example, I'm not going to be adding an event ID. And if you are not also adding an event ID, make sure that you're not sending a purchase event if you're sending a purchase event via the API, or if you're sending a lead via the API, make sure that you're also not sending that lead event via the browser, because if not, there's a chance that you might duplicate your data. The event source URL, this is where the web event occurred. So this is where you could potentially put that page where the user converted. I'm not going to put anything because this is a demo, but this is where you would add it. The test event code, so that's important that you add that there, because this is how we're going to make sure that our Zap is working correctly. So I'm going to go in Events Manager. If you're not too sure how to get there, if you click this, Business Tools and Events Manager, is going to bring you to this page and make sure that you have the right pixel selected. And for me, it's the demo pixel. And before we get the test event code, we're actually going to connect our Events Manager to Zapier. Click on Settings, and I'm going to scroll all the way down, and I'm looking for the conversion API, and you're going to have to choose a partner. As you can see, for me, it's already connected to Zapier, but if you would choose a partner, you would click on Zapier, and then you would just click Connect, and then automatically it's going to close, and you'll see that under Connected Partners, Zapier will be there. Once it's connected, you're going to go to Test Event. And if you scroll and if you look at the right here, this is actually where you can get the code to test server events. So we're going to click to copy it, go back in my Zap, and I'm going to add the event code here. One thing worth mentioning is that this code can only be there when you're testing and reviewing your Zap. So when it's time to actually launch this app, and when I'm going to click the on button, before I do that, I'm going to actually go back to this section and remove the test code, okay? So please remember that when your Zap is on, the test event code should not be there. Out of ads delivery optimization, they're saying select true if the event should only be used for attribution. So in this example, I don't want that, so I'm not going to set it to true. And data processing options country, and data processing options state, those are not things that I will be adding in this video because it's a demo, but if that's something that you want to add, this is where you go to add it. Now, customer information. This is where I simply have to pick the values that I have in my Google Sheet. So email, phone number, and I'm just going down the list and making sure that the email here matches what we see in the email. Okay, well, I've added the different values that I have in my Google Sheet. The rest that we see here are other options that you can pass on to Facebook, but I don't have that since this is a demo. But if you do have this information, I recommend that you add it because it will help with the quality match rate. And that is Facebook's ability to match the information that you are sending via the conversion API to an actual Facebook account. And if you go here and you set this to true, you can actually unlock more fields like date of birth, gender, and a few more. But again, I don't have that information, so I'm just going to skip this. The value, I do have that, so I'm going to add that. Currency, I'm just going to set it to Canadian. So the content ID, so this is the content ID associated with the event, such as a product SKUs for item in an add to cart event. The content name could be the name of the page or product associated with the event. So here they're giving you an example, lettuce. Content category, and this is the category that the content is associated with the event. So I don't have this information because again, it's a demo, but if you do have it and you want to send it to Facebook, you can simply add it here. And you can also add additional data. So if I click this link, Facebook is going to tell you what are all the custom data parameters that you can send to the platform. I'm going to hit continue. And now if I scroll down here, I can click test and review. And if I set this up correctly, we should be able to see a purchase event coming from the server using the conversion API. So we're going to click test and review. And now it says a purchase event was sent to the Facebook conversions just now. So let's take a look. Events manager. And perfect. We can see that we've actually sent a purchase event. And if I click here, we can see that we have a value of $30. The currency is Canadian. The action source happened on the website. And you can see all the user data keys. So the city, the email, the first name, last name, phone, state, and the zip code. And to confirm, this is a server event. If I click on server, you can see that it was only received from the server and not the browser. And now it's time to turn on my Zap. So I'm going to go back to Zapier. I'm going to click on setup action. I'm going to scroll and I'm looking for the test event code. And remember, we want to delete that because we don't want to have that in there when our Zap is on. I'm going to scroll all the way down and hit continue. And we're not going to retest it because we just removed our test code. So I can just go and publish this app. And perfect. We now have a Zap that gets triggered every time someone submits a form in the little form I created, and it sends all that information to the Facebook server using the conversion API.
All right. Thanks, Cedric, for showing us this technique. Now, as he has mentioned, this was more for demo purposes on how you'd be able to send data into the conversion API via Zapier. In real life, you might be doing this in a different way. Server-side tracking can be multifold. You could use, for example, GTM server-side to send the data into the conversion copy, or you could also use a script that you have written yourself on your server that sends that data over. But if you found this video helpful, I'd love for you to hit that thumbs up button so we can get some algorithm love for this video. And if you're interested in creating some cool tracking with the Facebook Pixel, check out this video right over here where Ahmad is going to give you a complete guide on how to get started using it. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.